What's happening, my queens, and welcome back to Resident Evil 7 Speedrun. Picking up where the last video left off, and can you left it at this bit. I got ice cream. I'm so glad to have done this series because this is the game and the final part of it. In the way that I have, because I've actually just enjoyed sitting here doing fuck all and just commentating and talking to you guys. I should do this more often. But yeah, I've just enjoyed chatting, talking shit. But in this episode, I thought it'd be fun to actually go rather than just talking random nonsense, to go and look through the news and find some really fun and interesting things to talk about. Be right back. I wrote them all down in a notebook, and I have a green fucking notebook. News report now. So I put my papers. So, in the news. Be great at this one, right?
We can't be a family.
What have I written?
We're never a family.
Oh, it's a bit on Emma Watson. Emma Watson believes that men cannot stand female heroes on the screen. Yeah. According to a column in Elle, after fan backlash to Star Wars The Force Awakens and Rogue One's female protagonists Rey and Jyn also, and all female stars remake of Ghostbusters, Watson goes on to theorise that it's something new, something they're not used to. Well, that's a lie for a start. And then goes on to argue that... Who's messaging me? Wait a sec. And then goes on to argue that men lack empathy towards female characters, whereas women empathize with characters on a more human basis, as opposed to by gender. Oh well. Let me start off by, you know, arguing the point that I'm male. You wouldn't think it, but I am. I'll show you. But now, I do love female characters. I've always argued the point that I do prefer female characters. As you know, with Doctor Who, I love Michelle Gomez as the Mistress, Alex Kingston as Riversong, and I'm all in favour for a female Doctor. But even still, even before all that, before, you know, Star Wars and Ghostbusters and stuff, it's nothing new. I mean, all stars, female star Ghostbusters, that was new. Kind of. For, you know, Ghostbusters for a remake of something that was all male. So yeah, it was nice to see that, and I'll probably get a lot of playing over it, but I did actually support the Ghostbusters for doing what they did, for having an actual female cast, and I loved all the actors in it. I thought they were great. And I'm a big fan of Melissa McCarthy. Love all her work. regards to Rey and Jyn Erso in Star Wars, about them being the main protagonist, how fucking what? There's females in all the Star Wars movies. There's Princess Leia, there's Queen Amidala, or Senator Amidala, depending on where you got into it. But it's not new. I mean, I know they are now taking the mantle of the main protagonist, but it's still nothing new. I mean, look at Lara Croft, Tomb Raider movies, Angelina Jolie. Nothing new there. I still enjoyed that. So now, it's nothing new, and we are used to it. So, sorry Emma, but you know, that's just, you know, wrong. And on terms of empathy, that men only empathize towards other male characters because they can place themselves more in that role. I'm quite switched off to a lot of characters though, because I can't place myself in any of their roles. I mean, I'm not there to put myself in that role, I'm there to watch and enjoy a fucking movie. And in terms of empathizing with them, I empathize with anyone, male or female. As I say, I'm a big lover of female characters. I empathize a lot with them. But I also empathize with a lot of male characters, especially huge story based characters, you know, like Big Boss from Metal Gear. You just knew I was going to be on camera, didn't you? Every time. Yeah, with Big Boss having to kill the Good Boss, you just empathize with him for what he has to do. So, again, I think she's wrong. But that's my opinion on it. I'd be interested in your guys' opinions. What do you feel towards what she says? Do you agree with her? Do you agree that men don't like female characters because they don't empathize with them or just not used to them? Or do you agree with me and just think that she's just total bullshit? But since she's been on this like huge feminist thing, hasn't she? She's been a bit obnoxious. I mean, I'm all for women's rights. I really am. I'm all for equality on every possible basis. Whether you're male, female, gay, straight, another race, religion, whatever, you're all human. And all AMD right to be. What else have I got here? Oh, new details for Project Scorpio have been revealed by Microsoft. Games will now run at 4K, promising to be the most powerful ever console, even to eclipse the power of Power C and Power the Eclipse of PlayStation Pro. Specs include CPU custom times 86 core at 2.3 GHz. And GPU 40 units at 1172 MHz. 12 GB memory RAM. Standard 1 TB hard drive. Disk drive will be a 4K Ultra HD Blu-ray with a current estimate price of £400. So that's pretty close to what like the PlayStation 4's launch price was. And on terms of like specs and stuff, that seems really good. I mean, not huge on like computer components and parts and stuff. But I know that's like huge, it's a lot of a huge upgrade from what consoles are now, anyway. Ever if they be running standard on 4K. That's quite the achievement that they've made. Actually, no, I'm more of a PlayStation user. I mean, I have had Xboxes in the past. I had the original Xbox, Xbox 350, and I did enjoy them. But I do enjoy PlayStation more, but that's my opinion. But I do see the upsides to all consoles, to both sides of them. I did particularly enjoy the Xbox 360's layout, though. Loved that. And the Avatar system was brilliant as well. Oh yeah, this Project Scorpio seems amazing. I like this one, I just read here. Get ready to run. No wonder. The Telegraph have reportedly said that Harry Styles is the modern day David Bowie. No. You do not compare Harry Styles to David Bowie. No. So this comparison got made after the debut of his new single, since going solo from One Direction. Looks like they're all doing it now, doesn't it? So much One Direction, they're all going in different ones now. But no, that is insulting. As much as I understand people will like his music, but you do not compare a modern artist to a classic like David Bowie. You just don't. It's like when all the thing of who will take up the mantle of the King of Pop. Nobody will take up the King of Pop after Michael Jackson's mantle, that when Michael Jackson died. Nobody will take that mantle. It goes with him. And the same with David Bowie. There will be no one in the world else like David Bowie. I'm sorry, but no, you don't compare Harry Styles from One Direction to David Bowie. What else have I got written? Oh, this one made me laugh. This news article. I forget the place where I actually got this one from, sorry. But real life clowns are not happy. With Stephen King's It movie following... Real clowns are not happy with Stephen King's It movie following the release of the trailer. With the remake of the classic 1990s TV adaptation featuring Tim Curry as Pennywise, and the trailer saw 192 million views within 24 hours of release. Real life performers who slap on a smile and blow up balloons for a living and entertainment reporters. These are quotes, by the way. I've written these all down as quotations. Who keeps fucking texting me? You have to get out of here and find her. Claim that it stigmatizes the profession and that business is already being affected, comparing it to Jaws, which saw an increase in fear of sharks and water. But unfortunately, unlike it, Jaws is unrealistic and has levels of detachment. So basically, feel like clowns are complaining that they're not happy about Stephen King's It having a new remake out. And complaining that it's stigmatizing all clowns. And their business are now being affected because of. I'm not being funny, but who the fuck in this modern day and age still orders clowns for parties? I mean, seriously, who is you know, thinks that looks okay for a fucking child's party when they first came up with clowns and stuff. Because they're terrified anyway. Not being funny, but blaming Stephen, the new It trailer. Shouldn't have really badly affected your business. If anything, it should have fucking upped it from, you know, say the Mastic people. Sorry, that's, well, yeah, say the Mastics and Masochists and stuff. You want to be hiring clowns now? That Stephen King It is coming out. I'm looking forward to that. I love the original TV adaptation of it. Tim Curry was amazing as Pennywise. So yeah, if you guys want to get in on any of these fucking news pieces I was talking about, feel free to leave comments in the section down below. We'll have a little banter, we'll talk about it, we'll discuss our points. But just like that one though, and some of them quotes were from an actual Scottish clown. Forget his name. Giggles or something like that, his name was Giggles the Clown. It was something stupid. Comparing It to Jaws. You can kind of see where he comes from, but then he backtracked on himself by saying that at least the shark had a sense of unrealism. I'm not being funny, but he has clearly never watched It. The things that clown can fucking do. It still doesn't stop that level of fear from being achieved. Also, what do you guys think of the new trailer? I mean, it looks like pretty much a take-for-take remake of, you know, Tim Curry's version of it. The original TV version. But I reckon it looks alright. I mean, no point of fixing something when it's not broken. Just give it a bit of spit and polish. Speaking of things that I've been watching, I've been watching these fucking brilliant fucking YouTube videos on this instrument. It's new to me, I only found out about it yesterday. I mean, it's probably been out for a while, but I know it's currently taking the internet by storm. It's called the Automatone, and honest to God, some of them fucking instruments are the funniest thing I ever saw. The first video I ever saw was the Chocobo theme tune of it. But honest to God, I was watching this one video today of the Automatone's Ave Maria. Honest to God, go watch it and laugh. And then come back and thank me and treat yourself to it. Honest to God, you will love it. It's great. Just search Automatone, which I believe is spelled. I don't know how to spell it. OT. AMAAMATONE Automaton. So OTAMATONE Automaton. And search Automaton Ave Maria. Answer God. It's funniest fucking video I ever saw. Fuck that, he's not Ned. Where's getting me fucking glove and everything? So I was saying in the last Resident Evil video that I'm currently doing a clean up on the trophies for doing the DLC stories, which I'm going to be recording tomorrow. And we have already fucked up on the resource management trophy. Because we've got how many times it takes the weapons off you near the end of the game. So it's either that or I'm going to have to run through the fucking game barehanded. Which is, you know, just not going to happen. I've already used the item box 3 times. And I'm only just up to the wrecked ship. So that's a no go. But I've already got the Duck If You Love Life trophy. I got that one. And actually really amazing progress towards the No Healing Items trophy. Well, the limited use healing items, you only have to use 3. I haven't used any yet. Yeah, I'm quite close to making Resident Evil 7 my 10th platinum trophy. Because even though I'm not going to get that item box trophy, I kind of know where I went wrong and, you know, how to get back and fix it and stuff. Did anybody notice them on the gameplay? That I did drop his shotgun, but yeah, he still shot with the handgun. Yeah, the handgun. Pralines and cream. What thinking I need a ciggy, but no, that's fucking smoking him up. Been having terrible reactions to cigarettes and. Probably could say it a lot of time as well, but I'm not saving so often. So I was kind of trying to keep checkpoints and stuff. From when I've done the MGS4 speedrun. It was always important to make a lot of save often and create a lot of checkpoints. So that you can go back and rectify any mistakes. We should have to complete that game within 4 hours. And that was a longer game than this as well. Am I the only one who thinks that Evelyn looks like a young Mia? Or even to the point that she'd be a sister or something, looks related to her? Love the reveal of it. Oh no, I do love it. That old woman who was stalking us through the fucking mansion the whole fucking time was Evelyn. The main thing behind it, and it was always there from the beginning, fucking surrounding us, following us. I really did enjoy this game. And here we are, the last round of boss fight. Didn't even call it, that's just basically an interactive cutscene, to be honest. I wonder what it was that kicked off. Second World Cup, or whatever they're called now. The events that's been happening here. And who the hell are, you know, the little boys? But they'll be added in the next, whatever, Resident Evil's. Maybe it's added in DLC, I don't know. But we're not going to play about this. They will be coming as they are starting to record until then tomorrow. Do you think it took them off long enough now? The thing is, because it's just not long done, and I told the sense of relief when you actually get to this point of the game is unbelievable. Anyway, I think I best do my outro now, I think. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. Let's wait it on. So if you guys like this video, hit the slap that like button, maybe even subscribe because all your support for this channel really does help. All my comments and subscriptions do go an awful long way, especially your shares because more people share this too. They're bigger and better than me anything you possibly build here at the Stereotype Gamer channel. Thanks again guys so much for watching this episode, and we'll be back with more Resident Evil. As we see, this is the last video this week. And we'll be back Monday. So till then, see you guys in the next video. Bye bye. I should do more of these fucking videos. I mean, this is going to be the last time I do this one. But I should do more, you know, post-credits. Because I enjoy just sitting here just chatting shit. Anyway, guys. Bye. Mwah. Be a good idea if the video cut here, like, but... going to cut off mid-sentence, to be like the Sopranos episode, you know, where that